Hi, Gabby from Ray Studios, and today I'm going to be talking all about Canon full-frame lenses. Well, the reason I'm making this video is because this is kind of like a follow-up to another video that I did before about the Canon 5D Mark II, in which I kind of like review it, but in modern times. So it's like, I think the video is called Canon 5D Mark II still works in 2018, so that was from last year. Nonetheless, what I'm trying to say here is that if you are going for an old DSLR full-frame camera like the Canon 5D II, 5D III, 5D I, the original 5D, it's probably because you don't have too much money, but you like the full-frame look. But if you don't have too much money, of course you're not going to have too much money to buy these expensive lenses. So whenever you watch a video where people recommend lenses for, you know, for full-frame, they're probably very expensive. They're all like L-rings and stuff like that. But I'm gonna give you some alternatives that are very affordable. Basically, this video is gonna be it. So first, I'm gonna start talking about the lens that I have in my camera, which is the 24-105 f/4L. And I know it's not the cheapest lens, but to be honest, when it comes to the L-ring, I think it is the cheapest. And when you consider the value what you get out of this, it's not that expensive. It's actually it's almost on par with some crop sensor lenses, like the Sony 18-105 f/4, and this one is almost the same price. So considering this is full frame, it's optically stabilized, it's pretty sharp, it's great. It's really good. You can use it for video, for pictures, and there is a reason why this lens is always attached to professional photographers. You know, you see anybody with a 5D 2, 3, 4, they're shooting events, and you're probably always gonna see this lens at some point or another one. And it's because it's very versatile, it's reliable, it's very good. And even though it's a little expensive, it probably will cost you more than the camera, it's really worth it. Now, I'm gonna start talking about the cheap lenses. And of course, I have to talk about the Nifty 50. This is what everybody will recommend you, and there is a reason why. It's fantastic, it's sharp, you have relatively good bokeh. The bokeh sometimes can be looks very busy, but I mean, if you are a beginner, an amateur, or whatever, and you probably won't even notice it, but it is really good. Autofocus is great, it's silent. This is the STM version, so it's the Canon 50 f1.8 STM, and look at how small this is. It's almost like a pancake lens. It's very small, lightweight, just put in your backpack, costs like $100, brand new. So, fantastic lens, I really love this lens. You can do portrait photography with this. You can actually do everything, because 50 millimeter is not like, it's not too wide, but it's not too tele, it's right in the middle. It's like what your eye see, that's what this lens see, and it's great value for money. I mean, $100, that's very cheap. Now, if we keep talking about cheap lenses, I have to talk about this one, and this is something that you will never hear in a video. It's not a very common lens. This is the 24 f/2.8, and this is the non-ultrasonic version, which means that makes some noise, like when it's focusing, but it focuses really fast, it's very sharp. F2.8 for an ultra wide angle lens, so 24 millimeters, kind of like ultra wide, it's pretty good. To be honest, it's pretty fantastic when you think about it. I bought this one for about $100. So it's about the same price like this one. So these two complement each other really good. So you could just have these two lenses and you're pretty much covered for, I wouldn't say everything, but you get a lot with these two lenses. So you get ultra wide, you can do events, and this one you can do portrait, you can get close, you can get far. I mean, these two with $200, you have a lot of versatility with these two lenses, and they're prime. It means image quality is gonna be very good. No matter, this is second hand, I bought it. It's of very old, it's like 20 year old lens, but it works so well. So don't count this out. Now, I'm gonna talk now about lenses that are a little bit more specific. Believe it or not, even so this lens is, look how this big this is. It's like bigger than the camera itself, right? And you will think, you will believe that this is very expensive, but actually it's not. This is the Sigma 120-400mm f4.5-5.6 APO HSM, that's a pretty long name. It has great stabilization. It's basically a really long telephoto, so if you are into telephoto kind of lenses, like you want to shoot wildlife, birds, or you're a total creep, this lens is great for you. So basically, you don't need to get close to your subject. Autofocus works great. Image quality is pretty decent. I mean, I have not much complaint about the image quality. You can take some really nice picture. It's a bit dark, like 4.5, 5.6. You're shooting at night, forget about it. Even so, the stabilization is pretty good. I would keep like a 1/500 of a second just to make sure it's very stable, so the image looks sharp. So yeah, I wouldn't recommend it for indoors or at night, but I don't think that was what this lens was meant to be. You can hold it from here because it's pretty heavy. And I think this lens is somewhere around $700 brand new. I bought it like $400 second hand. Can't remember exactly, $400 or $500, something like that. So not very expensive for such a beast as a lens, and it's pretty good. Now, let's talk into my most expensive lens for the EF mount, which is the 16-35mm F4 IS. This is a L lens, and you can see that beautiful red ring. L lens. Basically, that's what you get when you want to show off. But no, actually, this lens is really, really good. Image quality, I believe, is one of the best ultra-wide zoom from Canon. This and the 16-35 f/2.8 Mark III, and that costs like a lot of money, like $2,000, while this costs like $1,000. So it's expensive, I get it, expensive, but I need it. I love ultra-wide angle lenses, and that's the reason why I bought this lens, no matter how expensive it is, because I really like to have ultra-wide. So it's hard to get to 60mm with any other lens, and the prime lenses from Canon that do 60mm, they're also very expensive. So yeah, for me, this is worth it, even though it's expensive. But there you have it. That's all the lenses that I have. I think to round it out, you could just buy this one lens that cannot do it all, or if you're in a super tight budget, you can just buy these two that are prime. Actually, these two, these at 24 work much better than this one at 24, and this one at 50 work much better than this one at 50. So if you don't need that telephoto 105mm, these two will do better, cost less. They're super small and light. So yeah, if you're on a budget, I recommend these two. You have a little bit more money, I recommend buy the 24-105 and a 50, so you can throw that background out. You know, you will get a nice pocket with this. And if you happen to have more money, you can go ultra wide and telephoto, and you have basically the whole range of focal ranges. That's it for today. I hope you like this video. If you like it, please make sure to give me a thumbs up. Leave me a comment in the comment section down below. Let me know what you think, which lenses maybe I'm missing, or which lens do you think you would like to buy. This is Gabby from Ray Studios. Till next time.